I will tell you the process of founding Han Dynasty according to historical records of Gaozu Benji. Liu Bang was called rogue by his fellow citizens, and he liked fighting, drinking, and telling lies. His job was called the Si Shui Tingzheng, which is equivalent to the leader of militia in his hometown. To become a full-time officer in the Qin Dynasty, other officers must recommend him. Liu Bang was poor, because he had many friends who can fight in his hometown, he was recommended to be the Tingzheng of his hometown. However, they didn't belong to official government employee and had no salary. If Xiao Ho, an officer of Pei County, wanted to find Liu Bang for some missions, Xiao Ho would provide Liu Bang with money in the form of temporary appropriations. When Liu Bang was 40, he still had no achievement. If Liu Bang didn't meet Liu Gong, Liu Bang's life might have passed as a loser. Liu Gong was a rich man from Shandong. He was a good friend of the chief of Pei County and moved his families to Pei County in order to avoid revenge. In Chinese history, the husband of a daughter was selected and determined by father. Liu Gong had a daughter named Liu Ji. The chief of Pei County once told Liu Gong that he wanted to marry Liu Ji, but Liu Gong hesitated to agree. In order to propose marriage, the county chief specially organized a reception party for Liu Gong. In fact, the county chief wanted Liu Gong to marry him to Liu Ji earlier. The rich people and officials in Pei County heard that the chief invited Liu Gong to have dinner. This was a good opportunity to sacrifice their boss, and went to the party with gifts. Liu Bang also went.
Xiao Ho, the secretary of the Pei County at the time, was responsible for organizing the party. He said to the guests that those who donate less than 1,000 money will be seated farther away. The one could sit closer to Liu Gong and chief if he donates more than 1,000 money. Liu Bang lied to Xiao Ho and said that he would donate 10,000 money. When Liu Gong heard such a large amount of money, he walked to the door to pick up Liu Bang. Liu Gong liked Liu Bang's appearance very much. Liu Gong invited him respectfully to sit closer to him. Liu Bang wanted to deceive people without giving a penny. Xiao Ho knew Liu Bang and quietly reminded Liu Gong, "Liu Bang is a man who loves to talk big, be careful of this guy." But Liu Gong smiled. Liu Bang was drinking, eating and bragging. When Liu Bang was ready to run away after dinner, Liu Gong quickly signaled to him to stay and talk alone. Liu Gong and Liu Bang had the following dialogue. Liu Gong asked, "How old are you?" Liu Bang, "More than 40. Liu Gong, "Are you married?" Liu Bang, "What's the matter? Will winter worry of getting married?" Liu Gong, "I have seen a lot of people, and the most expensive one is you. I have a daughter and want to marry you, okay?" Liu Bang seemed a little disbelieving and thought he heard that wrong. Liu Bang was brave and thought that since you dared to marry your daughter to me, I dared to marry. Anyway, Liu Bang doesn't suffer. Liu Bang happily agreed to the marriage. However, Liu Gong's wife was not satisfied with the marriage. The chief of Pei County is a good friend of the Liu family. Liu Bang cannot be compared with him in money and social relations. Why doesn't marry their daughter to such a good person? Why marry Liu Bang who is old and had no money? Are you lose your mind? Liu Gong said disdainfully to his wife, "This is not what you women know."
Everyone felt incredible. If Liu Gong was not a prophet who knew physiognomy, he must be stupid. Why would he marry his daughter to a poor man? Why didn't Liu Gong marry his daughter to a wealthy county chief? Everyone in the county has to obey the order of the chief. The chief was richer than Liu Bang. Liu Gong insisted on marrying his daughter to Liu Bang despite the opposition of his wife. Don't you think it's incredible? Physiognomy is the ability to predict a person's destiny by looking at his face, which is difficult to explain with modern technology or discipline. Liu Gong liked Liu Bang's appearance. Through Liu Bang's appearance, he judged that Liu Bang would have great power and wealth in the future. This was called physiognomy in ancient China. Just like in the movie The Matrix, the old lady Oracle saw Neo's appearance and said that he was the savior. In thousands of years of Chinese history, there were many similar physiognomy records. During the spring and autumn period, emperors had destroyed books many times. Almost all the books that recorded the history of China's ancient times have been burned except Shan Haijing. let us know very little about the history of China's ancient times. We can only know a little by word of mouth and Shan Haijing. At present, there are a little physiognomy books in China, but I can hardly believe the authenticity of the remaining physiognomy books. Physiognomy may be a kind of research statistics and analysis of human genes, or it may be taught by God. Or some time travelers went back to the past. Physiognomy is of great antiquity, and in ancient and medieval times it had an extensive literature. It was related to astrology and other forms of divination, and this aspect of the subject bulked large in the fanciful literature of the Middle Ages. There is evidence in the earliest classical literature, including Homer and Hippocrates, that physiognomy formed part of the most ancient practical philosophy. In the East or the West, there was no modern transportation and communication technology in the history. Without any communication, the East and the West had many similar capabilities or technologies. Physiognomy was one of them. For physiognomy that modern peoples do not understand, I would like to ask, was physiognomy developed by ancient humans? Or was it taught by God to ancient humans? Choosing husband for daughter is very important, and it is more careful than investing millions of monies. Liu Gong judged that by Liu Bang's appearance. I believe that Liu Gong was the person who knew physiognomy, and the use of physiognomy in his decades of life not only made him rich, but also many successful uses made him more and more confident. In addition to physiognomy studies, there are so many interesting and bizarre things in the Chinese history that I will tell later. This is one of the reasons why I am very interested in Chinese history.